So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, Abu Bakr and Umar, they are outside and they are looking for something to eat. And when they stop by the Ansari's house, and his wife tells them that he is not here, and he comes radiallahu anhu and he gets them some dates to eat, and he takes a knife to slaughter something for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and the Sahaba radhiyallahu alayhim. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam is asking him, do not slaughter anything that gets milk. Al-halub means any cow or any animal, a sheep, a goat that gets milk. He said, avoid that. So don't slaughter that, because this is good for the family. And then the Ansari, he slaughtered for them and he cooked some meat for them and they eat some dates. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam tells Abu Bakr and Umar, وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِهِ. Again, he is making an oath again. By him in whose hand my soul is, لَتُسْأَلُنَّ عَنْ هَذَا النَّعِيمِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. You will be asked about this na'im, this bliss, this luxury on the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah. You left your houses hungry, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made you go back and you are full. So you can imagine what happened to the Sahaba radhiyallahu alayhim during that time. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam himself was leaving his house out of hunger. And if you remember when they built the masjid, and after that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam used to get some stones and some rocks, and he ties them on his stomach under his clothes out of being hungry and there is nothing to eat. And this was the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So the way from Mecca to Medina and after Hijra was not easy for the Sahaba radhiyallahu alayhim, and even the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, they faced many difficulties and they found many obstacles on the way, and it wasn't rosy and beautiful right after they finished the Hijra. And then we can take another hadith from Sahih al-Bukhari. Sayyidina Aisha radiallahu anha, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam wife, qalat al-Urwa ibn al-Zubayr, she is telling her nephew Urwa ibn al-Zubayr, inna kunna lananzuru ila al-hilali thumma al-hilal thumma al-hilal, aw ila al-hilali thumma al-hilal thalathatu ahilla fi shahrayn, وما أوقدت في أبيات رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم نار، فقلت يا خالة ما كان يعيشكم؟ قالت الأسودان التمر والماء، إلا أنه قد كان لرسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم جيران من الأنصار كانت عندهم منائح، وكانوا يمنحون رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من ألبانهم فيسقينا. عائشة is the Prophet's wife and she is telling Urwa ibn Zubayr what happened to them back in time. She said, one crescent moon, and then the second crescent moon, we can see two moons in 3 months. 3 months pass by, and we have never lit a fire in the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam house. Litting the fire means we haven't cooked anything. We just were living and going by, and we didn't cook anything. So he's asking here, my aunt, how come you, what was the food for you during these 3 months? She said, the two black things, dates and water. For 3 months, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, not just one house or one wife, all of his wives, all of his houses sallallahu alayhi wasallam, they do not have something to be eaten, and they just live on water and dates. Another hadith, Sayyidina Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu narrates. He says, جَاءَ رَجُلٌ إِلَى رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ فَقَالَ إِنِّي مَجْهُودٌ فَأَرْسَلَ النَّبِيُّ إِلَى بَعْضِ نِسَائِهِ فَقَالَتْ وَالَّذِي بَعَثَكَ بِالْحَقِّ مَا عِنْدِي إِلَّا مَا. Someone came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and he looked very tired, hungry, and he said, oh Prophet of Allah, I'm very tired and hungry. So the Prophet sent to his houses, his wives, and they all say, by whom, who sent you to the people? we have nothing but water. All his wives, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, مَنْ يُضِيفُ هَذَا اللَّيْلَةِ رَحِمَهُ اللَّهِ. In the masjid, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam can see a man, he is hungry, he is tired. And the Prophet's houses, they don't have anything to be eating except water. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the masjid is announcing, can anyone here take this brother as a guest and feed him? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward him with rahmah. Allah will be merciful to him. Then one person, one sahabi from the Ansar, he said, me ya Rasulullah, I will take him. فقام رجل من الأنصار وقال أنا يا رسول الله فانطلق به إلى رحله فقال لامرأته هل عندك شيء. The man took the brother who came and he went home to his wife. He's asking, do we have anything home? قالت لا إلا قوت صبياني. We don't have anything except the food that I'm preparing for my kids, for my children. قال فعلليهم بشيء فإذا دخل ضيفنا فأطفئ السراج. Make the children busy with something, anything. They can play with something, make them busy. And then when the guest comes in, you just turn off the light. فَإِذَا دَخَلَ ضَيْفُنَا فَأَطْفِئِ السِّرَاجِ وَأَرِيهِ أَنَّا نَأْكُلْ فَإِذَا أَهْوَى لِيَأْكُلْ فَقُومِي إِلَى السِّرَاجِ حَتَّى تُطْفِئِي. So when he comes from out, if the house has 2-3 lights, you turn off almost all of them except one. And then when the guest comes and he starts sitting, we will try to show him that we are eating. We just pretend that we are eating. And once we start eating, you go and turn off the last light. Turn it off. And she did this. And the guest was eating, thinking that they are eating. So he ate the food of these Sahaba ridwanullahi alayhim. And then what happened? فَقَعَدُوا وَأَكَلَ الضَّيْفِ. They sit down and the guest eats. فَلَمَّا أَصْبَحَ غَدَى عَلَى النَّبِيِّ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. So when the Fajr time comes and they meet the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, قَدْ عَجِبَ اللَّهُ مِنْ صَنِيعِكُمَا بِضَيْفِكُمَا اللَّيْلَةِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have been amazed with what you have done with your guest tonight. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was very happy, amazed of what you have done with your guest that night or tonight. So you can see the status of the Sahaba ridwanullahi alayhim, the status of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. His house doesn't have food, and when a guest comes to him sallallahu alayhi wasallam in the masjid, he announces who can host the guest of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and Ansar takes him, and even the man who is hosting, he doesn't have enough food, and he is just telling his wife to turn off the lights to pretend to eat so the guest doesn't feel shy or anything. And then when he starts eating, they stop eating until he eats and he is full. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and tells him what they did during the night time. So once the Sahabi meets the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam is telling him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loved what you did with your guest last night. So this Sahaba and the Prophet, they suffered. Why? Because out of being like they have no money, the finance was zero, because they left everything behind and they prepared for Hijrah and they paid all what they can to the Meccans and the disbelievers to let them out with themselves. And then when they come into Medina, not too many people are rich. Even the Muhajirs, the Ansars, who offered them money, it wasn't that much that will be enough for everybody. So they started working, but still, Medina was not like Mecca. Mecca was a hub for many businesses. Many people come from Syria and from many places to Mecca to buy and sell. Medina wasn't that. So it was not easy for the Sahaba Ridwanullahi alayhim and for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to live that tough and rough life. And then if we can come and relate this to ourselves nowadays, how good and how well we live and how much food we throw away because we just ate it one day or 2 days and we don't like to eat it for the fourth day. Sometimes our fridges and freezers at homes, they don't have spaces for food. You come and think about this. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam leaves his house. Abu Bakr and Umar, they leave their houses and they have nothing to eat. And they go out to look for food. And these are the best of humans, the Prophet and the two Sahaba ridwanullahi alayhim. And we are having so much food, so much ni'mah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but we do not thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for what we have. We do not thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sometimes people say, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by saying alhamdulillah. Saying alhamdulillah, you have to mean it. You have to praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not just with your tongue. It has to come from the heart. And also, it has to be manifested on the limbs. Jawarih. You have to practice the praise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the shukr or the hamd, when you thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it has some rules and etiquettes. If it is just, if you thank someone, or if you thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you have to go through these rules to be really a thankful person to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or to someone who has done a favor for you. And if we go and see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, He sent to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, revealed many ayat about being thankful. When he subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَذْكُرُونِ أَذْكُرْكُمْ وَشْكُرُوا لِي وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ. Remember me, I remember you. And thank me, be grateful to me, and do not be ungrateful to me. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also tells us in many ayat, وَإِذْ تَأَذَّنَ رَبُّكُمْ لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ وَلَإِنْ كَفَرْتُمْ إِنَّ عَذَابِي لَشَدِيدٌ. And your Lord have decreed that if you are thankful, He will give you more. And if you are ungrateful, His punishment will be severe, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says also, وَسَيَجْزِ اللَّهُ الشَّاكِرِينَ. Allah will be the one who rewards the ones who are thanking Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also says, وَقَلِيلٌ مِّنْ عِبَادِيَ الشَّكُورِ. Just a few among my servants are thankful and grateful. And also, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us, Sayyidina Usama ibn Zayd narrates the hadith, and he says, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, مَنْ صُنَعَ أَوْ مَنْ صُنِعَ إِلَيْهِ مَعْرُوفًا فَقَالَ لِفَاعِلِهِ جَزَاكَ اللَّهُ خَيْرًا فَقَدْ بَالَغَ فِي الثَّنَاءِ. When somebody gives you something or makes a favor for you, and you say, جَزَاكُمُ اللَّهُ خَيْرًا, you have thanked him or her. At least, say, جَزَاكُمُ اللَّهُ خَيْرًا. And then Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu narrates another hadith. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, مَنْ صَنَعَ إِلَيْكُمْ مَعْرُوفًا فَكَافِئُوهُ فَإِنْ لَمْ تَجِدُوا مَا تُكَافِئُونَهُ فَادْعُوا لَهُ حَتَّى تَرَوْا أَنَّكُمْ قَدْ كَافَأْتُمُوهُ. If someone does something good for you or does a favor for you or makes you a favor, gives you a favor, so you have to reward him. And if you don't find anything to reward him or her, make dua for him or her. So dua and saying جزاكم الله خيرا, it really matters with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us in many hadith, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explains about the way of shukr. And also the ulama, when they come to the way of shukr, to say thank you to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala about the ni'am, we are healthy, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. Sometimes we have some complaints. If you have some complaints, go to the hospitals and see the people are living there. They are not sitting there for a while, they are living in the hospitals because they get many serious disease and they have to stay there for a long time and they have to leave family and they have to leave their money and the houses and everything and they stay in a room for 24/7 and then sometimes we have time to go and visit and sometimes we don't even have time to go and visit and they stay in the hospital for a long time and we do not know and appreciate the ni'mat, as-sihha, the health, until we see those people who are sick. And you sometimes do not appreciate what you have and say, I don't have a job, But still, alhamdulillah, you are eating, you are drinking, you have a car, you have a house, you have everything. You have children, food, everything. Rizq is there and you are alive and you come to the masjid. MashaAllah, that's very good. And then we still complain. So look around and see those people who don't have anything. Those who are homeless. Those who have no family member to take care of them. Those who may have some money, but they don't have any friends or family. And the money cannot benefit them. So you have to say Alhamdulillah and thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why the ulama said, if you want to thank Allah for His favors, or if you want to thank someone for something He has done to you, you have to go through some rules. The first one, خُضُوعُ الشَّاكِرِ لِلْمَشْكُورِ. The one who is thanking should submit himself to the one who is giving him the ni'mah. If this is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us the ni'am, so we have to submit ourselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to thank Him. The second rule is حُبُّهُ لَهُ. You have to love the one who gives you the ni'mah. So submit ourselves to Allah and then love Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then اعترافه بنعمته. You have to talk about it and say Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, Allah has given me this. وَأَمَّا بِنِعْمَةِ رَبِّكَ فَحَدِّثْ. And the bounties of your Lord, you have to talk about them and speak about them and say Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Because many people, Allah has given them lots and lots of things, yet they are complaining and saying, we don't have anything, we are poor, we don't have that, we don't have that. And instead of saying Alhamdulillah, we are okay, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us, they try to see the negatives. And they say, no, we don't have this. We are looking for that. And they may have this or that. So we have to love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, submit ourselves to Him, and also to manifest the ni'mah. And then, thana'uhu alayhi biha. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you or me something, we have to thank Him and acknowledge what He subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us. Or if someone helps you in a situation, you have to acknowledge this too. And the Prophet told us, whoever does not thank the people, does not thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If someone helped you in any situation, you have to thank him or her. If you don't, you are not thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then, لا يستعمل هذه النعمة فيما يكره. If Allah has given you something, do not use that against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If Allah has given you health, do not use your health and go and commit sins and make the ma'asiyah and be against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remember who gave you this power, this health, these two hands and the feet and the eyes and everything. It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He has given you this ni'am and then you are using it against Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Or if someone is helping you during this time, for example, if somebody helps you to get a job in a company and then you have become in a good position in that company, and later you push that person away from his position. The one who helped you to get in, you try to conspire against him and get him away from the company because you have become now so and so, and you have a position, and you are powerful, and you can do this. This is not good. If someone helps you, you have to help him, and you do not use what he has helped you with against him. And when it comes to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we should submit ourselves totally to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, at the best of the creation, when he wakes up during the right time and he prays the whole night until his feet are cracking sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, swelling sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and Aisha, out of her love to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, asking him, O Prophet of Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forgiven you all your sins. Be easy. Why you do this? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam answers, أَفَلَا أَكُونُ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا. Aisha, shouldn't I be a thankful slave? He is thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by Qiyam al-Layl, he is doing it. And we know Allah has forgiven him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam everything. But he is the example. He wants to be followed sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by his family and by the Sahaba ridwanullahi alayhim. So shukrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you love someone, you give him the nasiha. And when someone does something good for you, help him and also give him the advice and the nasiha. This is the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam talking to Sayyidina Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiallahu anhu, says, Wallahi ya Mu'adh, inni la uhibbuk. O Mu'adh, be Allah, I love you. فلا تنسى أن تقول في دبر كل صلاة اللهم أعني على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. So the Prophet, out of love to Mu'adh, he has given him some jewels. He said, Mu'adh, do not forget after each salah to say, اللهم أعني على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. My Lord, help me to do the ibadah and to remember you and to thank you. If you say this after each salah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you more reward and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will love you. And then Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu too is narrating the hadith, and he is saying, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, اللهم أعني ولا تعن علي وانصرني ولا تنصر علي وامكر لي ولا تمكر بي واهدني ويسر الهدى لي وانصرني على من بغى علي رب اجعلني لك شكارا لك ذكارا لك رهابا لك مطواعا لك مخبتا وإليك أوابا ربي تقبل توبتي واغسل حوبتي وأجب دعوتي وثبت حجتي واهد قلبي وسدد لساني واسلك واسلل سخيمة صدري. This is in Sahih al-Tirmizi, this is the best dua for shukr. To thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has given us this prescription when we come to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. اللهم أعني ولا تعن علي. Oh Allah, help me and do not help people against me. وانصرني ولا تنصر علي. Make me victorious and don't make people victorious over me. وامكر لي ولا تمكر بي. And plan for me and do not plan against me. Oh Allah, اهدني ويسر الهدى لي. Guide me and make guidance easy for me. وانصرني على من بغى علي. And make me victorious over those who are planning against me and oppressing me. رب اجعلني لك شكارا. My Lord, make me thankful to you. لك ذكارا, reminding myself always with you, always remembering you. لك رهابا متواعا, always obeying you and making salah to you. مخبتا إليك أوابا منيبا, coming back always to you. رب تقبل توبتي. Oh Allah, accept my tawbah, my repentance. واغسل حوبتي, and clean up my sins. وأجب دعوتي, and answer my دعاء. وثبت حجتي, give me the good proof on the day of يوم القيامة. واهد قلبي, guide my heart. وسدد لساني, and give me the good argument when I speak. وسلل سخيمة صدري, and clean up whatever bad in my chest. So this is a dua the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prescribed to us. If we want to thank him subhanahu wa ta'ala, we use these words to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the best of those who made shukr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are the Anbiya and the Rasul, the Prophets and the Messengers. They are the best of the creation who used the ni'am of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For example, Ibrahim alayhi salam, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ إِبْرَهِيمَ كَانَ أُمَّةً قَانِتًا لِلَّهِ حَنِيفًا وَلَمْ يَكُ مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ شَاكِرًا لِأَنْعُمِهِ اجْتَبَاهُ وَهَدَاهُ إِلَىٰ صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. Ibrahim was a nation by himself, one ummah by himself. قَانِتًا لِلَّهِ حَنِيفًا, he was always praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, straight on the deen. وَلَمْ يَكُ مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ, he has never been among the mushriks, the polytheists, or the kuffar. شَاكِرًا لِأَنْعُمِهِ, he was always thankful for the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why اجْتَبَاهُ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen him. وَهَدَاهُ إِلَىٰ صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ, Allah guided him to the straight path of him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sayyidina Nuh alayhi salam, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ذُرِيَّةَ مَنْ حَمَلْنَا مَعَ نُوحٍ إِنَّهُ كَانَ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا. Nuh was a thankful slave. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is praising Nuh alayhi salam. And finally, Al-Imam Ibn Al-Qayyim rahimahullah, and Ibn Al-Qayyim is one of the big scholars in our deen, and he is one of the big ulama rahimahullah. He says, how to achieve shukrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala, these ni'am. We said the Sahaba and the Prophet, they have many difficulties and they don't have what we have nowadays. Still, they become the best believers and they fight for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they live for Allah, and they die for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then how can we achieve the shukr, to be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Ibn Qayyim said, الشكر يكون بالقلب خضوعا واستكانا. Thanking Allah to be with the heart, submitting yourself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, khudu'an, submitting yourself, your heart, it has to submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wastikanatan, wa bil lisani thana'an wa a'tirafan, and with your tongue, thana, you praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala a lot, wa a'tiraf, you confess, and you say, alhamdulillah, Allah has given me this, Allah has given me that, i'tirafan bil lisan, wa bil jawarihi ta'atan wa inqiyada, and with the limbs, they should obey and be submissive and follow the heart. So the heart, first, it has to be submissive to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The tongue, second, it has to speak about the ni'am and to say, thank you Allah, alhamdulillah, rabbil alameen. And then the jawarih, the limbs, they have to follow the heart and the tongue in thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he said also, وَشُكْرُ الْقَلْبِ أَنْ يَسْتَشْعِرَ القلب قيمة النعم التي أنعمها الله على عبده وأن ينعقد على الاعتراف بأن المنعم بهذه النعم الجليلة هو الله وحده لا شريك له وما بكم من نعمة فمن الله. So the heart has to recognize and realize that the ni'mah that we have is from Allah. I am alive, I am a Muslim, I am able to come to the salah, alhamdulillah, I am able to say alhamdulillah, this is a ni'mah. To speak, some people don't speak. Some people cannot see. They still believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they do the obligations and the nawafil. But we see and we talk and sometimes we are short. So the heart has to submit and the tongue has to confess and the jawarih, the limbs, they have to practice what is in the heart and what is said by the tongue. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا بِكُم مِّن نِعْمَةٍ فَمِنْ اللَّهِ. So brothers and sisters, inshallah, bi-idhnillah, we should take the lesson from the story of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Sahaba, what they faced in the beginning of da'wah in Medina. It wasn't easy for them. And we have to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because we are not in the same situation they were. We are in a better situation. We can use the ni'am that we have nowadays to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to get away from the shaitan, to get closer to Jannah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to get closer to the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it doesn't matter if you make some people angry. What matters is, if Allah is pleased with you, that's all. You will be saved in this life and the afterlife. And sometimes to please Allah, some people will not be happy with you. And this is the norm, this sunnah in the universe. Always the people on the truth, they have many enemies on the way. But these enemies will never take you away from your goal, which is the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The road for the prophets and messengers, the best of the best, was very difficult road. They have gone through many tests, and they were very certain on la ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. The Sahaba radhiyallahu alayhim, they carried the same light of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and they spread around the whole world teaching la ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. They did not sit in Medina after the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam died, saying it's the best place and we sit there. They spread around the whole world teaching La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, and some of them did not even have the means to do so, but they have done this out of their love to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, feeling the responsibility that they have to carry out this heavy message to all the corners of the universe, because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam commanded them to do so, and he taught them sallallahu alayhi wa sallam how to be a responsible Muslim. Nowadays, we have to learn how to be responsible, how to be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We don't sleep and leave Salat al-Fajr or Salat al-Isha. We don't stay home and we can come to the masjid and we don't come. We do not help people and we can help. We do not offer things which we can offer, but we prevent ourselves from ajr. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us to be among the shakirin, those who ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiveness and thank him subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask him subhanahu wa ta'ala to be grateful to him subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask him subhanahu wa ta'ala to direct us to the best path, the path of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask him subhanahu wa ta'ala to open our hearts towards la ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. We ask him subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us to use all the means we can for da'wah to Islam, for la ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. We ask him subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive our sins, to accept our a'mal, to grant us jannah, maghfirah and rahmah. Allahumma aghfir lana ma qaddamna wa ma akharna, ma asrana wa ma a'lanna, ma anta a'lamu bihi minna, anta al-muqaddim wa anta al-mukhir wa anta ala kulli shayin qadir. Sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammad, an-nabi al-ummi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, wa jazakumullahu khairan.